It still fascinates me.
The incredible beauty of the universe.
I call it a marathon and not a sprint.
We never wanted to be in second place.
Whatever I wanted to do, I felt that I could do it.
Sights, sounds, and smells are all around us, competing for our attention.
You have 14 urgent messages.
But when do these instances turn into thoughts? For more than 50 years, Michael Posner has been studying the elusive workings of the mind.
So in the 1960s, we measured mental operations, or what we might call subroutines that made up the task.
Posner believed that there were deep mental processes associated with attention and other behaviors.
I made an observation. I asked people to match two visual letters, but I found that when I asked subjects, it always took about 80 milliseconds longer to match if the letters were in two cases than if they were physically identical.
A new discipline was established. Cognitive psychology enabled researchers to measure fundamental mental operations over time. For Mike Posner understood that 80 milliseconds makes a difference.
In the 1970s, we were able to use people with brain injury to establish a link between operations that are involved in switching your attention from one location to another. Was the brain operating as a whole, or was there localization of function? In a way, I think we solved that problem by showing that it wasn't the whole brain. It was a set of rather scattered neural areas that carried out the subroutines involved in the task.
Posner delved into the nascent world of neural imaging to enhance his study of mental processes.
You have to remember that it isn't like now. Neuroimaging wasn't an established way to figure out brain processes underlying cognition.
Today, Mike Posner continues to work with young scientists around the world, demonstrating how attention processes can be developed in infants and also used to alleviate stress.